The cloak will wait, as it did all those years that I was away. I will one day wear it for my stepfather, who loved me so dearly. Today he is here in the whisper of the trees, leaning over the river by the council buildings. So is Barker, in the glitter of sunlight on the stones, the sheen of live feathers, she who told me that one day I would be a healer, fully rounded, caring for my family and the wider world. I want to prove her right. Auntie Kath, sensing I might feel discouraged, has given me a new ponamu. Shaped like the mere of my dream, this one has known no violence. It was blessed at the last full moon, washed in the sparkling ocean. It hangs warm and heavy around my neck. Forum North is packed with graduands, family. My former classmates will soon march along the streets, gowns and hats on, celebrating the end of this part of their learning journey. I sit near the middle of the auditorium with young Willa. Jackie has just had a miscarriage and is resting at home with her toddler, Tama. We are surrounded by friends and whānau of the graduands, who sit in the front rows in their gowns and cloaks, waiting to receive their degrees. They giggle and mutter and preen, illuminated by the flash of cameras. Willa seems as excited as they are, twisting in her seat, pointing out the mayor, imagining she's seen Stan Walker in the crowd, squeezing my hand. We all hush as the ceremony begins. My mind flits back to my last school prize-giving, and the hāngi, and Rick, and everything that followed. I lift my chin and remember that I am Mila, the descendant of healers. Those things long gone cannot be changed, and I mustn't allow them to poison the present. I no longer haunt the places I don't walk and am trying to live my life as one whole.